Today, our show ends forever, appeasing thousands of YouTube commenters from the last 5 years. Also, Donald Trump loves Hispanics, while the media loves his panics. Finally, the Republican nominee is determined, which makes sense considering their mascot is a fat, loud monster who crushes everything in its path. Ladies and gentlemen, from Chicago, Illinois, my name is Sam Bowers, and this is the series finale of Lamestream Media. North Korea will be holding its first Workers' Party Congress in the last 35 years, a gathering of the country's most powerful political body, which is not to be confused with the country's largest political body, Kim Jong-un's. Paul Ryan says he is not yet ready to endorse Donald Trump as president. Honestly, Paul, endorsing Trump for president is pretty much just like removing a Band-Aid. You will expose a gaping wound that will get infected and you'll die. Donald Trump posted a picture on Cinco de Mayo of him eating a burrito bowl with the caption, "I love Hispanics," just in case you were wondering how ISIS started. Caitlyn Jenner will appear naked in an upcoming edition of Sports Illustrated, which won't be the first time the magazine has featured women with balls. California has increased its legal age to buy cigarettes to 21 years old, which means now you won't be able to get your hands on cigarettes or alcohol until you turn, like, 14. The Romanian hacker known as Guccifer says he easily hacked into Hillary Clinton's emails. While it's only a matter of time until someone is clever enough to hack into Bernie Sanders' scrolls. Researchers in California say Los Angeles is ripe for a massive earthquake that could kill thousands of people. While an erupting fault line would be devastating, it does remain the only way Ted Cruz can return to the underworld. Ted Cruz announced last week that he is suspending his presidential campaign, a bit hypocritical, as I thought he opposed late-term abortions. Last week, the unthinkable happened.
Lord has a purpose for me, as he has for everyone. And as I suspend my campaign today, I have renewed faith, deeper faith, that the Lord will show me the way forward and fulfill the purpose of my life.
We are suspending our campaign.
That Ted Cruz has dropped out. CNN has confirmed John Kasich, the Ohio governor, he's dropping out as well. You're the only one left right now.
That's good.
Donald Trump's inevitable Republican nomination marks the end of Lamestream Media, ladies and gentlemen, because I have failed. On July 20th, 2011, I embarked on a journey to invoke a liberal political revolution on YouTube. You see, at the time, there was a vacuum for liberal political satire on the internet, and I ultimately just wound up yelling into one. 215 episodes, 1,672 subscribers, over 6 million views. All great numbers, but all for naught, because Donald Trump has secured the Republican nomination. So, rather than wallow in my shame and trudge forward as yet another straight, white, Stephen Colbert plagiarist, I feel that I would rather end everything right now. So I will swallow my shame by swallowing this Trump steak. Like a cyanide capsule in a soldier's pocket, I have kept this Trump steak under my desk for the last 5 years, just in case I ever were to need it. Unfortunately, today is that day. A final thank you to everybody who helped me produce this show over the last 5 years, beginning with Tom Bryan, Russell Cordell, and John Dietrich from KCAT TV 15, who provided facilities and equipment and technical support for the first 3 years of this show back in Los Gatos, California. A thank you to my parents, Kim and Craig Bowers, for providing so many voiceovers throughout the years. Thank you to Michael Gardner for producing and performing and reading so many haikus during the early years. Thank you so much to my various script supervisors, the people who assess the jokes prior to publishing them every week. That would be Ryan Glyden, Eric Eastland, Andy Alder, Laura Alder, Strange Dave Fuller, Chayton Whiskey, Clayton Howard, Laura Palmer, Jeff Graham, Bill Nielsen, Stefan Perez, Celine Elliott, and Jeremy Kapow. Thank you so much to my various directors that I've had over the years, Dom Balestri, Oliver Berger, Nina Kramer, Chris Diamond, and of course, Weston Bulger, who directed over 125 episodes of Lamestream Media. That's more than half of the episodes we ultimately did. Another thank you to Michael Niederman, Tamale Sepp, Tony Ward, Kevin Kantorsky, and Nikki Hoffman for making it possible for me to bring this show all the way across the country and produce it here at Columbia College of Chicago. And finally, thank you to the loyal few who are texting me during this monologue. Thank you to the loyal few who watched this show over the years. I know the show wasn't always, if ever, good. And we produced a lot of content, but there were definitely a few of you who sat there and watched and supported every single one. So, as Samuel Chassie would comment and say, your attendance was quality as usual. So, ladies and gentlemen, enjoy your Trump presidency while I enjoy this Trump steak.
Oh. Oh, God. Well, I'll tell you, if the next 4 years of Trump's presidency are anything like this steak, well, it's just going to be a rough next 4 years. I'm out of jokes. Ladies and gentlemen, for one last time, from Chicago, Illinois, my name is Sam Bowers, and this has been Lamestream Media.